So they're a 6. All the others are 6.5, except for the Sportivas, which are a 7.
Hello, I'm Vicky, and I've been really lucky testing all these amazing shoes for Wild Ginger Running YouTube channel. I'm a fell runner, long distance runner, trail runner, and have been for about sort of 10, 15 years. And I've been doing lots of running while we've been in lockdown, testing out all of these. So I think we'll start with these as they're next to me. So these are the Hoka Evo Jaws fell shoe. They are incredibly light, and as you can see, they've got a really impressive grip with really big lugs on. Hoka shoes are usually really high off the ground, really thick with cushioning. These still have decent cushioning, but are quite a toned down version. These fit my feet really, really nicely. So they're kind of, I would say, a normal foot fit. I do have to lace them quite tightly, so there's quite a lot of scope in there if your feet are a little bit wider. The grip in these running downhill is brilliant on muddy terrain, rocks it's pretty good on, uneven ground, flying down grass descents, these are brilliant. I can really just let go and go as fast as I want to with these, and I do feel really confident that I'm not going to slip even in really wet mud. They're comfy to wear on roads, even running towards a fell, and on trail and on fell, so a pretty good all-rounder. I've probably run about 100 miles in these, just under, and you are getting quite a line across there and a bit of creasing here. They haven't gone through yet, and the material feels fairly solid, but that's the only thing that I've noticed with these shoes, that depending on how long you wear them for, I don't know whether that would come through or not. They haven't done for me, but we'll see how they go. So these are the Saucony Peregrines. These are a size 6.5. I normally wear a 6 in normal shoes, so went with a size 6.5 for these, and they fit perfectly. Initially, I wasn't too keen on these and they felt really hard and really heavy, but I have grown to absolutely love them. They take quite a bit of breaking in, which is unusual, and I'm not used to having fell shoes that do take breaking in. I can usually wear them straight out the box and be quite comfortable in them. These are brilliant because they've got a really thick cushioned sole, but it's not clumpy. It's got brilliant grips on the bottom. I'm running on grass, mud, downhill descents. I feel very confident in these. They're not slippy on downhill road descents, but I don't trust them quite as much as some of the others in the test. But they're a really, really comfy shoe. I can quite happily wear these for 17, 18, 19 miles, and they're absolutely fine. I've got really, really used to these. They're, I would say, a standard fit in terms of width of your feet. I've not had any discomfort in wearing these, even on long runs. Toes feel absolutely fine. They're just comfy. I could wear them every single day to run in, and I think they're a really good shoe. I've probably done about 200 miles in these, and they, apart from being dirty, again, they're faring really well. There's no obvious creases, apart from, you know, a teeny one across the front there, but nothing on the edges that look like it may split or anything like that. So yeah, really comfortable, good fit, all round decent shoe, this one. So this is the La Sportiva Mutant. I had to get a bigger size in this. All the other shoes are a 6, 6.5, and I had to get a 7 in this shoe. They are a really small fit, so I would probably suggest going up half a size to a size in this particular shoe. I love the fit of this shoe. They have a wrap where the tongue wraps around your foot and then closes up on the other side, which works as a bit like a debris gaiter, and you don't get any stones or anything in this shoe. Again, I would say they take a little bit of breaking in. I think the first couple of runs in them, they feel a little bit heavy and a bit clumpy, but as your foot gets used to them, I love these. I did a 29 mile race in these, the only race I think I've done in the last 6 months, and these were absolutely fantastic. And that was a mixture of really boggy fields, fell, tracks, a bit of road. So they're a really, really good all round shoe. Again, I've probably done 200, 250 miles in these, and there's absolutely no sign of wear at all across the front of the shoe. They're holding up really well. Again, they're another really quite cushioned shoe, and they've got a really good level of cushioning all the way along, and they're a really snug fit on the heel as well. Some people might find that the heel's a little bit high at the back. You can't wear low socks with these. You do need a sort of full sock. It hasn't done on me, but I could see why some people feel that might dig in a little bit. So just choose your socks wisely. It's got a really good grip, and again, this has had quite a lot of mileage, and there's not really any signs of wear. Despite the lugs not being quite as big as some of the other shoes, the grip on these is fantastic. So yeah, I've been really, really pleased with this. Good on road as well, on wet road, going downhill, things like that. I feel really confident that I'm not going to slip in these. So yeah, really snug fit, really nice shoe, different design in terms of cupping your foot at the front. And yeah, really impressed with these. So these are a men's shoe. I actually got sent the ladies 6.5 and it was far too small. So they sent me the man's 7, but they are exactly the same. He said the men and the ladies sizes is identical. So you can order the man's or the women's and they won't fit any differently. And there is also, I've just found a lace garage. I've run hundreds of miles in these and never noticed, but there is a nice little lace garage there to tuck your shoelaces in. Notice that. Clumpy. Clumpy but comfy. But only up to about 8 miles. They're a funny shoe, these. Everyone loves how these look, aren't they? So these are the Scott Supertrac 2.0. Absolutely gorgeous looking shoe, lovely colour. They are quite a wide fitting shoe, and I think if you've got wide feet, these are probably better for you than some of the thinner shoes in the test that we're doing. These are a size 6.5. I would normally wear 6, 6.5 in shoes. So again, I would probably stick with your normal size pretty much for this shoe. They are really, really comfy to wear. They've got a really, really thick cushioned sole the whole way along, especially at the heel. So you don't feel any stones or debris if you're running over rough ground. I find, because of the wide heel section here, if I'm running on tussocks or fell, I do roll a little bit in these, and I find them a little bit unstable for me at the back here, and I have rolled my ankle a couple of times in them. In saying that, if you were just on trail, these would be a really lovely, comfy trail half marathon shoe or something like that. They're thick and cushioned inside, so you've got a nice cushioned fit around your shoe also. The grip is really good actually. It's got really quite big lugs on here, and you can see it's quite wide here also. The grip is good, but what I tend to find is I get blisters from this section here. That's the only thing, and I know a few people have said that with Scott shoes, so it might be worth changing the insole and seeing if that would actually help. I think these are great for about 8 miles for me on trails, then I get a bit of wear in here, so I might have to look into how I can adapt the inside to fit my feet better. So these are the Salomon S-Lab Speed 2. And as always with Salomon shoes, you can take them out of the box, you can run in them, they don't need any breaking in. They are just, they're always the same, they're really, really comfy. I loved these, I really like the look of them, they look really smart. They fit as a standard Salomon fit, I would say, which I think is quite a narrow fit. They fit me perfectly. I've run in Salomons for years and years and years. I love the quick tie lacing. It's always a favorite of mine. And again, you've got your lace garage at the top this time, where you can tuck your laces in to stop them coming undone. This is a size 6.5, but they are big, which is unusual because I've always run in a 6.5 in Salomon, and these I would say are half a size too big for me, which is unusual. So just, you know, be aware with the size of this, you might need slightly smaller than you would normally order. They've got the traditional amazing Salomon grip. It's always been fantastic grip. It's absolutely brilliant. Perfect for any trails, any fell. I don't mind running on the roads in these because I always think they're really comfy. Even if it's, you know, just for a few miles till you get to the fell, the grip's fantastic, and I've always felt confident running in the grip on Salomon shoes. This one's probably done about 15 miles, something like that. I've not done an awful lot in these. And again, the longevity of Salomon shoes is generally quite good. I know people say they do tend to split here. This material seems quite tough, and I don't anticipate that it would split easily or anything like that. They're a lovely comfy fit around your shoe. The tongue comes up quite high, again, so you don't tend to get much debris in your shoe when you're running. But yeah, good shoe, really like this one.
Stealthy design.
They are, aren't they? Yeah, they are. I think they're a gorgeous shoe. I think they're really, really nice. And they've got really sort of, the sole doesn't come up on the side. It's a really narrow fit if you're racing or running through tussocks. You can get really good foot plantation on those. These are the Walsh PB Extreme. Oh no, they're not, sorry. It's the PB Elite, isn't it? These are the Walsh PB Elite. Is that right? PB Elite Extreme, they were both. Walsh PB Elite Extreme shoe. And these are the very first fell shoe I ever owned because I grew up in Bolton and Norman Walsh makes all his shoes in Bolton. So it's the first one I ever owned. So there's a little bit of nostalgia in this shoe for me. I think it would be fair to say they haven't really changed an awful lot in about 20 years because it's a formula that works and a lot of people race in these. They have a really good grip, very, very uniform, got a stone there, very, very uniform grip, and the grip on Walsh shoes is fantastic. I think they fit a normal shoe type, sort of fairly standard foot width. What is interesting about Walsh shoes is the upper material is a lot softer, I think, than many of the fell shoes out on the market. You know, it's a lot softer material than the Scott one, the Saucony and the La Sportiva. And I think when I was younger, I used to find that when they got wet, they're a little bit rolly and your foot doesn't feel quite as stable. I'd say that's probably still a little bit the case now. When they get wet, the material's not quite as supportive as some of the other shoes on the market. And I also feel in these that my heel isn't cupped quite as tightly as it is with some of the other shoes in the test. I feel that my foot feels like it's gonna come out a little bit on this. They're a really good shoe. They're, you know, you can pick them up for quite a decent price. This is a size 6.5, and I would say fits a normal shoe, normal foot width, foot size. So if you're normally a 6.5, you'd probably get a 6.5 in this one. They're a good shoe. A lot of people really like them. There are newer shoes on the market with different technology and things like that. I do find the laces on these are the sort of very traditional laces, which for me come undone. They came undone as I was running back to the car, actually, just here as we were doing our test. So you might want to swap the laces out in these for something that would stay fastened a little bit more. Yeah, and a lot of old people wear these, don't they? They're very, if you've learnt to run in them, you stick with them really, don't you? I'm just gonna check the name. This is the Inov8 X-Talon G235. We say X-Talon, apparently it's actually cross-talon. I have learnt something today. Apparently in the Inov8 circles it's cross-talon and we've all been saying it incorrectly, so there you go. Inov8 shoes are amazing. They're one of the most popular brands on the market for fell shoes. I would say they're quite a standard to narrow fit. I don't know whether people with wide feet find these particularly comfy, because I think they're a really quite a close fit on your foot. They're a fantastic shoe. These are really light to run in. They fit well around the foot, and then they've got quite a nice heel cup here. They're not as hard, this particular pair, in the heel as some of the earlier models, which used to rub quite a lot in the back here, and I know a lot of people suffered with that. They seem to have made these a lot softer to accommodate for that, so these are better. This is a size 6. Most of the other shoes in the test are a 6.5. They're probably a teeny tiny bit small for me, but the 6.5 would probably be too big. So I would say they're about the right size that you would normally buy in shoes, or go up half a size perhaps, but I wouldn't go any bigger than half a size. The sole is quite cushioned, but if you're running on road to get to the trails or fell, I wouldn't want to be going too far in this one on the road. I didn't find it particularly comfy running on the road to get to the trails from my house in this particular shoe. The grip is amazing, as always. It's the Inov8 fantastic grip, probably the best grip out of all the shoes here. You're confident with it, you know you're not going to fall. It grips well in mud, it grips well on grass, gravel, things like that. I don't think anything grips on duck boards and wet wood, but these are probably the best bet I would go for in terms of grip. So yeah, nice fitting shoe, standard lace fittings. They did come undone a couple of times for me, that's something I did notice, so I would have to make sure I really knotted these to keep them fastened in a race. And there isn't a lot of cushioning on the sole, on the tongue, it's quite thin, so I would wear quite a thick pair of socks with these just to help with cushioning from tying the laces quite tight, otherwise it can hurt your foot quite a bit there. So just something to consider.
Oh, is it the Race TT? I thought it was the Forest.
I thought it was the Forest too, but it says Race TT on it.
Oh, that's weird.
The box said Forest too, but then it just says Race TT on there. Protector.
Protector.
Protector to protect your feet. It does, doesn't it? These are the NVii Forest 2. These are a new shoe, which haven't been around for a particularly long time. We thought initially that it was NVii, but we've been told that no, it's actually NVii. So that's how we pronounce this brand of shoe. They are a similar fit to the Inov8s and the Salomon, a reasonably narrow fit here around your foot. And again, quite thin on the instep, thin on the instep here. As most race shoes are really for that precision placement where you put your feet. These are a size 6.5 and they're a perfect fit for me. I'm usually a 6 in normal shoes and tend to go for a 6.5 in race shoes. These are really, really light. That's the first thing I noticed when I put them on. They're incredibly light and they feel nice on my foot. They've got a reasonably thin sole here, so if you're running on the road to get to the trail or the fell, you will notice it's not particularly comfortable and you won't want to do more than a couple of miles, I would say. They're a nice fit around the heel and they hold your foot firmly in place. Again, they're another sort of race shoe that has the very thin tongue, so you don't get a lot of cushioning from the front of your foot there. They do have the protector section here to try and help when you bang your feet on the rocks and things like that and it really hurts. That's quite a nice addition to this shoe. The grip is really good. I've been quite impressed with it so far. I've got no reasons to complain. I've done about 30 miles in these and these have been really good. They're a nice shoe. I don't think I'd wear them for anything over 30 miles because for me there's not quite enough cushioning in them, but they are comfy, they're a good fit, and I've been pleased with how they've performed so far on trail, fell, and things like that. So to buy these from NVii, they're £155, which is a heck of a lot of money for a shoe. We did find them on another website, Kong, for £115, so they're slightly cheaper on there. It's a lot of money to pay for a shoe when there are possibly others on the market that are significantly cheaper and probably quite similar. I've not seen anything particularly special about this one that makes it stand out from, say, the Salomon, the Inov8. Which one was vegan?
The Walsh's.
Was it the Walsh's? Yeah. Not even vegan friendly. There'll be a sudden surge in sales for Walsh's. Who would say that? With regards to these shoes, there's quite a marked difference between the top three and the bottom three. These three, I think to look at, it's quite clear to see that they're more of a trail shoe. The grip is really, really good on them, but with regards to running, if I was doing a long distance trail stroke fell, I'd be using one of these, probably one of these two. That's my personal favourite for a long distance trail run. If I was doing a short fell race, then these are the ones I would be picking from. And I'd probably say my top two would be these two for a short fell race, but I wouldn't really want to wear any of these shoes for a race over about 8 miles. Because for me personally, it's probably not quite enough cushioning in there for my liking, and I'd be picking something else. First choice for the grip, I think really, it's a close call this one actually, because they are really, really good. There's none of them that I would say, oh, the grip's rubbish on that shoe. They're all really, really good. My personal favorite would probably be the Inov8 or the Salomon, but also the grip on the Hoka is really, really sticky. And that was a real surprise as well. They're all really good grips and you wouldn't have any problems in any of them running off road. But yeah, I'd say the best grip really is these three here.